Hello, this is Chris Thomas. I'd like to show you a product that I use and recommend to all my students. It's called a Masterson Stay Wet Palette. Now, they make palettes in a variety of sizes, but the one that I use is the 12 by 16 inch. I use it for both my acrylic painting and oil painting, and I want to show you what it consists of. So it's basically like sort of like a Tupperware box. And it has in it a sponge and a special moisture wicking paper. Now the way you start this is you soak this paper for about 10 minutes in water, and then you soak this sponge as well. The sponge doesn't take as long to soak, just get it thoroughly wet. Put the sponge back in, put your moistened paper back on top, and then you're able to put your acrylics out in here. It keeps your acrylics from drying. They won't dry all day long. You don't have to keep misting them with water like you normally do if they're out on a regular palette. One thing I would recommend that's different than the directions, and I haven't heard anyone else say this before, is at the end of the day, I pull my paper out that has the paints on it, and I'll pull it out like this onto a table, and then I pull the sponge out and wring a lot of the excess water out, and once I've done that, I pull my paints back in before I seal up the palette. Now, sealing the palette is a little bit difficult. It's got a tight seal on it, and in the directions they tell you to put some Vaseline around the edges. I don't do that because I don't want to actually accidentally brush up against the Vaseline and get it on my arm or something. Here's a recommendation for how I put the lid on. Start with each corner first. Make sure you get each corner started, and then go nibble around the edges until you get it completely sealed back up. Now, that takes a little bit, but you will get it sealed up and you don't accidentally get Vaseline on you while you're using your palette. Now, the way I use it with my oil painting is I actually put my palette in the box, and then I put the palette in the freezer with my paints on it, and it keeps my paints wet for several weeks at a time in the freezer. The directions tell you not to put this box in the freezer, and I believe it's because the plastic gets brittle when it's really cold. So when I get ready to paint, I pull my box out and get my other stuff ready, and I allow this 5 to 10 minutes to come to a normal temperature before I start to pull the lid off. I've yet to have one break on me. So I open up the palette, and to get the palette out, I'm going to show you a couple different ways, but usually I will just tip it over like this and pull it out. A lot of people paint with their palette in the box. I don't like it in the box to paint, so I get my palette out of the box. Another way that you can helps to get the palette out of the painting is to take a piece of tape. And you can just leave this on here. I'll tape it here, fold the tape in on itself, and it makes a little tab for you to lift it out of the box with. And you can just keep that on your palette and flip it out of the way while you're working. Now, this paint has been in the freezer actually for about a week and a half to 2 weeks. And here is some of the paint that's in there. You can see how fresh it is. There's even some small colors right here, and they are still wet. So it's a nice way to save your paint and keep it from drying out. At the end of a painting session of a day, if I have a string of color that is something I'm using in a painting, I will just gather it all up and pile it up at the end of the day, pile up whatever I want. That's what I've done here. And then wipe the palette off and then put that in the freezer. I hope this little tip helps you out. Now remember, don't give up, have fun, and keep painting.